what I think the military needs to understand is, you guys know me, you know I'm not crazy for sure, like you're 100% certain I'm not crazy, at least the NSA does, and you've treated me like shit, and like you poke me, or you allow people to poke me, I think, and then that ends up with me poking you, and then you are like literally a threat to our country's national security. Like the way that you deal with us is a threat to the country's national security. So it's like, I know you want me to be nice to you, and I know that I should be nice to you because I'm afraid to go for a walk because I am afraid of the military because I know what the military is like. They kill people. They're Christians that kill people. And that's what I'm saying. Like, I understand, like, if there's anything I know, it's the psychology of a Christian that wants to kill people, which was me when I was in 10th grade. And it wasn't that I wanted to kill people, it's that I wanted to kill people that attacked us. And I thought that fighting our war in Iraq was patriotic, even though I didn't understand war, I guess, and I didn't fully think it out because I was a kid back then. And I wanted to be like my dad. But what I'm also saying is that if you have thought it out, and once you're in deep enough into the military, you have thought it out, you realize that like what you're doing is not a very good thing. Like it's like not a very moral thing. So it's definitely, if there's anything it's not, it's Christian. Jesus talks about turning the other cheek. The last thing he talks about is being assertive about making sure that your oil supply is taken care of. I'm the one that talks about being assertive about making sure your oil supply is taken care of. I'm the one that talks about being assertive about making sure that your country survives long term and not thinking short term because you're expecting someone to come back from the dead named Jesus and you don't know who he is. He might just be a rock star that your country imprisoned, but I don't even know that because seriously, I don't know. But what I do know is the military knows I'm not crazy. If there's anything they know without a doubt is that someone can send what would be the equivalent of a sound wave into my brain wirelessly, and they can communicate with me, and they can tell me things. The military is 100% certain about that. They're acting like they don't know. They know that my life has danger in it. They know that I've pissed off the Russians, and I've pissed off a lot of countries. Don't care that I don't have a gun, but they could say, hey, trust me, he's not crazy at all. Make sure I have a gun. They didn't do that, and now they're in deep shit because it's like, damn, now once he gets his gun back, it's like confirming that he's not crazy. But really, like the real thing is that the military is pissed off at me because Donald Trump is appointing the leaders, and Donald Trump is backed by some very serious, powerful people in Washington, D.C. who have something on Donald Trump that makes him very easy to deal with. So yes, Donald Trump's not a religious nut, but he uses the religious nuts to get votes, and he has religious nuts that are controlling him through what I would consider treason.